So we need a moral healing.
Yeah.
And this is the basic of every spiritual path.
Yeah.
This is the difference between psychology that doesn't really care about that, because it doesn't care about values in that sense. Yeah. It doesn't postulate any values. It postulates just understanding of what happens to you when your father beats you up and your mother doesn't love you or whatever there is. No. Yeah. But it doesn't give you, in that sense, a kind of moral teaching. No. Yeah. And moral healing means that the one who corrupts us within ourselves stops doing that. Yeah. That is moral healing. Yeah. That you understand from your own higher perspective that everyone has. No. Because as you have the divine ocean within you, of course, you have also the knowledge of it. Yeah, you have the clear message of it. Yeah. So in the game of La Ilaha Illallah, we said it yesterday already, there is no outcome. There is one outcome from the beginning of the game clear. You will end up with La Ilaha Illallah. Yeah. This is the title of the game. This is the end of the game. This is the beginning of the game. This is the middle of the game. It's the game at any point.
Yeah.
All right. And everything else is a dream within the dream. Yeah. Everything else we project, that we having relationships, that we having our adventures and so on and so on, is a form of dreaming. No? Yeah. Because the divine itself, yeah, has all the experiences possibly they can be. Yeah. There is nothing left. There is nothing that the divine has to experience yet. You understand? Yeah. And this is why you can understand what is right and what is not right. You can understand it because you have always this higher self, this higher I on you. That in the old text, it's called conscience. Yeah. And I love this word very much. It is actually a perfect expression of the divine voice. Yeah. When your conscience talks to you, that means God talks to you, right? And it talks not in a screaming way. It is not like intimidating. It talks in a very, very subtle and very intimate way, but very subtle. Yeah. You can easily overrun it, no? And this is what we need to understand from the divine nature, you know? Yeah. Of course, there is Qadr, there is the force, and the force you also will experience is actually the first thing you will experience. Yeah. But there is also the opposite of it. Yeah? Most tender, most loving, most sweet, most thing. And usually this is how he speaks to us. Yeah. And we don't want to hear it because we don't want to be reminded that we are not on the top of our behaviors, of our way we live the life. No. Yeah, we would like to be perfect. We would like to appear completely integral. No. So it's very hard to go and see the shadow self. And all the spiritual path is first of all about that. Yeah. No. Because in the light, in the perfection, there's nothing to do. What you want to do there, you know? So you have to go to the other, right? So this is why we have to come here, because in the light, yeah, there is just perfection. So there is no other. Yeah. You cannot learn there. There is no opposite. Yeah. There is nothing that can be reflected. So you need to come here where the shadow can appear. No? So it's an imperfect world. It's not an ideal world. Yeah. It's a very unfair world in a way. Yeah, it's full of injustices, full of not logic also, right? It's completely illogic. Yeah, some people are born like this, some people are born like this, and you ask yourself, why is that, right? Then of course you can say with past lives, but a life began once, right? So if you go all back, you would think that we all were the same. No, we were never the same from the very beginning. There was no, not the same. Yeah, because in the divine, there is no divine name the same. Yeah. Nothing is the same. If you notice in creation, not one snowflake is the same like the other, not one raindrop, not one atom. Finally, we find it out. Not one atom is the same than the other. Isn't it crazy? Right? This is why they want to stop the work in CERN, because it costs so much money and they cannot go further than what they have reached now. Yeah. So they found a myriads of particles, yeah, that are permanently fluctuating and changing and God knows what, and they give them many, many names, the beautiful one, the God one, the ugly one, the strange one, very funny names, but they can't find out what it is. Yeah, they can't really make sense of it. Yeah. So they say, okay, the thing is too expensive to run it for years and years, and we cannot go 1 millimeter further. Yeah. But one thing we have to understand within the simulation, yeah, which represents the world of mind, no? Yeah, the world of dream. That is what happens in the mind, right? It cannot be explained what is beyond it. No, it's that simple. So science will never be able to explain in the way science does at the moment what is the divine, yeah, or what is beyond what we cannot see now, and so on, right? So in us are these two beings, yeah, that one is at every moment in bliss, in the divine dream, in happiness, yeah, in utmost happiness, in utmost fulfillment, no? And how much you experience that has to do with the word consciousness, no? Yeah. So the more conscious, the more aware you become of it, the more you can allow it to be there, yeah, the more you experience it. But it is in itself infinite, right? Everything in itself is infinite, yeah. What is finite in this simulation is the physical, no? So we are projected, literally projected into it, yeah, with a dense body, but it's a projection. That this is why it's coming from the light. It is like the cinema. Imagine it like a cinema, right? Only that it happens in 3D. Yeah, it's projected, yeah, from the projector, no? The divine projector projects it, and it happens through light. Yeah, it's also interesting, right? It can only happen through light, yeah. And then we are into the movie, yeah. And it is written in the Book of Love, and he creates a situation, and we have to step into it, no? So it creates a film, yeah. And we have to step into it. So we are all in our own movie, you can say, right? And in that movie, we have certain roles to play. And we are chained to them, yeah? In Sufism, we say there are 5 chains, you know, that chain us to that role, yeah? That we have to play it, you know, play through it. One is desire, you know, very strong chain, yeah, because we are all the time into desire, one or the other, We want to come in a situation more. We want to come out of it. We want to have more from something. We want to have less from something. We want to be with that person or that person, and so on and so on. There is permanently an idea what we need and what we desire, right? So this is one chain. Then in the desires, there is this different qualities of desires. Not every desire is the same, right? There's different levels of desires. And the first one is what is called rajasi, which means it is purely selfish. It's very materialistic, no? And it is only to your own benefit, no?